Chia seeds cause inflammation. This is the claim being made by a medical doctor in a video that's been viewed over 1.4 million times. I did a real deep dive on this one and unearthed a brand new piece of research which I think is really important. So make sure to watch till the end. Let's take a look at that first video.
Chia seeds sound like a superfood. They have short chain omega-3 fatty acids and they make a jelly-like coating when you soak them. But buyer beware. In human studies, chia seeds increased inflammation in the subjects, despite the fact that their omega-3 levels went up.
Okay, this is understandably concerning. So I went searching for that study, and I came across this clip.
Now, I used to believe that chia seeds were a superfood at 1.2. About that time, I was approached to work on a book with the father of the paleo diet. We were chatting about recipes, and I happened to mention what a fan I was of chia seeds. And he stopped dead in his tracks and said, "Don't you read the literature?" He said, "Chia seeds are very inflammatory." I said, "What?" The study he referred me to was done to show that chia seeds have a short chain omega-3 fat, which they do. And the study was done with human volunteers to give them chia seeds. The other group didn't get chia seeds. And they looked at the amount of omega-3 fats in their blood. Lo and behold, their omega-3 fats did go up. But they were also looking at a marker of inflammation, which is C-reactive protein, in this case, HSCRP, highly sensitive or heart-specific CRP, and the chia seed group actually went up in their C-reactive protein. That was the point that most people had missed, that yes, the omega-3 fat went up, but the inflammatory markers went up as well.
But nowhere does he link or show the study. However, I heard Dr. Michael Greger cite a study that sounds almost identical to what Dr. Gundry was describing. So let's take a listen to that.
But the same amount of ground chia seeds did lead to a significant increase in blood levels of both short-chain and long-chain omega-3s. But there appeared to be no influence on inflammation or disease risk factors. No change in body fat, blood sugar, cholesterol, blood pressure, C-reactive protein, or any of the other markers of inflammation.
But was this the exact study Dr. Gundry was referring to? The only possible clue was in the description box of the video. It said, "I unveil the surprising facts about chia seeds, including their potential inflammatory properties due to lectins." Now, we've discussed lectins in previous videos, but long story short, if lectins were really a problem, we would see an increase in inflammation in those who eat lots of beans, as they're packed full of lectins. This study that prescribed 4 servings a week of legumes saw a significant drop in C-reactive protein, a huge 40% drop of this key indicator of systemic inflammation. CRP is important as it's one of our main inflammatory biomarkers. But then I came across this brand new research from September 2024, which was a meta-analysis of 10 randomized controlled trials, which looked at the effects of chia seed supplementation on a few different cardiometabolic markers. And researchers found that among other positive benefits, chia seeds reduced C-reactive protein by over 1 mg per liter, which is hugely significant. There were no differences in tumor necrosis factor alpha or interleukin 6. And in fact, amongst those 10 controlled trials, there were no signs of increasing inflammatory markers. Chia seeds also contain, amongst other things, chlorogenic acid, which is a powerful antioxidant, and a substance called caffeic acid, which may help fight inflammation in the body. The only caution I could find was the fact that dried chia seeds do absorb a lot of water, which causes them to swell up and greatly expand. So we should always soak them before eating to prevent risks of blockages and gastrointestinal issues. Next, we'll discover which are healthier, flax seeds or chia seeds.